Uh-huh.
I couldn't see in the limo when I opened the door.
Mm-hmm.
I couldn't see anybody's face.
Right behind the driver.
Must have been the sun.
Forever could never be long enough for me.
My God.
I feel like I've had long enough with you. Forget the world now, we won't let them see. But there's one thing left to do. Now that the weight has lifted, love has surely shifted. In my way, Mary, staying every day, Mary. If I ever get the nerve to say hello in this cafe, say you will. Never be close enough for me to feel like I am close enough to you. You wear white and I wear out the words I love you. And you're beautiful. And that the wait is over.
Good afternoon. A couple of passages of scripture from 1 John. God is love, and those who abide in love abide in God, and God abides in them. And from the book of Psalms 106, verse 1, O give thanks, for the Lord is good. God's love endures forever. Please be seated. We gather in the presence of God to give thanks for the gift of marriage, to witness the joining together of Rick and Heidi, to surround them with our prayers and to ask God's blessing upon them so that they may be strengthened for their life together and nurtured in their love for God. God created us male and female and gave us marriage so that husband and wife may help and comfort each other, living faithfully together in plenty and in want, in joy and in sorrow, in sickness and in health throughout all their days. God gave us marriage for a full expression of the love between a man and a woman. In marriage, a woman and a man belong to each other and with affection and tenderness freely give themselves to each other. God gave us marriage as a holy mystery in which a man and a woman are joined together and become one, just as Christ is one with the church. In marriage, husband and wife are called to a new way of life, created, ordered, and blessed by God. This way of life must not be entered into carelessly or from selfish motives, but responsibly and prayerfully. We rejoice that marriage is given by God, blessed by the Lord Jesus and sustained by the Holy Spirit. Therefore, let marriage be held in honor by all. And now Ed Nelson will come and read from Genesis chapter 2.
This is something for Heidi. Heidi wanted this out of her grandmother's Bible.
Called, he said,
taken from the man, and when he brought her to the man, the man said, "This one, at last, is bone of my bone, and flesh of my flesh. This one shall be called woman, for out of her man this one shall be taken." That is why a man leaves his father and mother, and clings to his wife, and the two of them become one body. Christian life. Beloved, let us love one another, because love is of God. Everyone who loves is begotten by God and knows God. Whoever is without love does not know God, for God is love. In this way, the love of God was revealed to us. God sent his only Son into the world so that we might have life through him. In this is love, not that we have loved God, but that he loved us and sent his Son as expiation for our sins.
Let us pray. Gracious God, you are always faithful in your love for us. Look mercifully upon Rick and Heidi, who have come seeking your blessing. Let your Holy Spirit rest upon them, so that with steadfast love they may honor the promises they make this day through Jesus Christ the Lord. Amen.
Amen.
Rick and Heidi, understanding that God has created, ordered, and blessed the covenant of marriage, we both affirm your desire and intention to enter into this covenant. Friends and family who are gathered here, do you give your blessing to Rick and Heidi and promise to do everything in your power to uphold them in their marriage? If so, say we do.
We do.
Now, Bethany and Emily, Brittany and Emily, first will read to us from Scripture.
Love is patient, love is kind, love is not envious or boastful, or arrogant or rude. It does not insist on its own way, it is not irritable or resentful. It does not rejoice in wrongdoing, but rejoices in the truth. It bears all things, believes all things, hopes all things, endures all things. Love never ends.
God of mercy, your faithfulness to your covenant frees us to live together in the security of your powerful love. Amid all the changing words of our generation, speak your eternal word that does not change. Then may we respond to your gracious promises by living in faith and obedience through our Lord Jesus Christ. Amen. For God, for meaning, Would you please repeat after me? Rick, would you say, I, Rick,
I, Rick,
take you, Heidi,
take you, Heidi,
to be my wife.
And I promise,
before God and these witnesses, to be your loving and faithful husband, in plenty and in want, in joy and in sorrow, in sickness and in health, as long as we both shall live. Heidi, would you repeat after me? I, Heidi, take you, Rick, to be my husband. And I promise, before God and these witnesses, to be your loving and faithful wife, in plenty and in want, in joy and in sorrow, in sickness and in health, as long as we both shall live. Place it on her finger. Would you repeat that? Heidi, I give you this ring as a sign of our covenant, in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Place it on his finger as repeat after me. Rick, I give you this ring as a sign of our covenant. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Let us pray. Eternal God, Creator and preserver of all life, author of salvation and giver of all grace, look with favor upon the world you have made and redeemed, and especially upon Rick and Heidi. Give them wisdom and devotion in their daily life, that they may be to each other a strength in need, a counselor in perplexity, a comfort in sorrow, and a companion in joy.
Together a sign of Christ's love to our world, that unity may overcome estrangement, forgiveness, heal guilt, and joy conquer despair. Give them such fulfillment of their mutual love that they may reach out in concern for others. Grant that all who have witnessed these vows today may find their lives strengthened, and that all who are married may depart with their own promises renewed. Enrich with your grace all husbands and wives, parents and children, that loving and supporting one another, they may serve those in need and be a sign of your kingdom. And grant that the bond by which all your children are united to one another may be so transformed by your Spirit that peace and justice will fill the earth through Jesus Christ, the Lord. Amen. From Mark's Gospel, the 10th chapter. From the beginning of creation,
God made them male and female. For this reason, a man shall leave his father and mother and be joined to his wife, and the two shall become one flesh. So they are no longer two, but one flesh. Therefore, what God has joined together, let no one separate. Heidi and Rick, before God and in the presence of this company, you have made your solemn vows to each other. You have confirmed your promises by the joining of hands and the giving and receiving of rings. Therefore, I proclaim that you are now husband and wife. Blessed be the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit, now and forevermore. Those to whom God has joined together, let no one separate. And Rick, you may kiss your God. Heidi, you may kiss your husband. Grace of Christ attend you, the love of God.
Say I do.